Hello, this is Sheshatulam from Astro Guide myself. Today we have to finish the Shadvarga, that is the sixth most important divisional chart after the D1. So we have done the D1 is the Rashi chart. Then we have this is the artificial sound which happens around us. Man-made. This is also beautiful. I love these sounds, so we both are okay with this. Train hooting. Okay. D1 is not to be considered as a divisional chart. So other than that, we have done D2, D3, D7, D2, D3, D7, D9, D10. So, Hora, Drakkana, Saptamsha, or Saptamamsha, Navamsha, Dashamsha. Today, I will explain what is Dwadashamsa. Dwadashamsa is the 12th division of each Rashi. This is very easy, that's why I am not using the board and I am outside today. So, just an explanation is easy, you people can do it. It's not a tough thing at all. And what do we see from Dwadashamsa is that we have to see the position of our forefathers, and that is the lineage. People should not tell me that I am male biased, because there is a word called forefather and there is no word called foremothers, foremothers. No, why it is like that? Because our earlier societies were all male the male factor was very prominent. So the male prominent societies have done that, and the point that the Y chromosome was taken so important that they wanted to see the lineage of the male child. So I think that was the thing. They could keep track, because the female chromosome they could not keep track. They did not have the mechanism to keep track at that time. So maybe. So, anyway, let me not get deviated. So, D12 means we can see our father, mother, grandfather, grandmother, then our lineage, our elders, to see whether we have been blessed or cursed by our forefathers. This is what is to be seen. Very clearly, it has been mentioned in Brihat Parashara Hora Shastra as to whether there is a Pitru Shapa or not. This Pitru Shapa has become a very big hype in all the online forums. I don't know why it has become such a big thing today, that Pitru Shapa Yoga, which we will discuss when I am taking the yoga classes, is not such a great yoga of difficulty. People should understand that many yogas are there which can be understood, because you can't do anything about it. First thing is that you cannot have remedial measures for all the yogas. Some of the negative yogas or some good yogas. It's like if you have a good yoga that somebody's son or daughter is going to thrive abroad, they even ask me that how can I stop this by happening. You cannot stop it by happening. They have to thrive, they have to go abroad and make a good name and a nice life. They will do it. You cannot stop it from that. So, it's a good yoga or a bad yoga will happen. So many things will happen. Only thing is that you can get informed earlier and you can handle it easily. So that's how it is. So forefathers can be seen from the D12. That is the Dwadashamsa. So, if you divide 30 degrees by 12, you get 2 degrees 30 minutes as one division. So that is, the 12 divisions are 0 degrees to 2 degrees, 2 and a half degrees, 2 and a half to 5, 5 to 7 and a half, 7 and a half to 10, 10 to 12 and a half, 12 and a half to 15. So 6 divisions. Once again, 15 to 17 and a half, 17 and a half to 20, 20 to 22 and a half, 22 and a half to 25, 25 and a half to 20, I did some mistake. I'll do once again. 15 to 17 and a half, 17.5 to 20, 20 to 22.5, 22.5 to 25, 25 to 27.5, 27.5 to 30. So that is how it has to end. Okay, so that is the division. So you can add the multiples of 2.5. So 2 degrees 30 minutes. So 0 degrees to 2 degrees 30 minutes is the first division. So the names of the Dwadashamsas are Ganesha, Ashwini Kumara, Yama and Sarpa, repeated 3 times. That is, the 12 pieces are Ganesha, Ashwini Kumara, Yama, Sarpa, Ganesha, Ashwini Kumara, Yama, Sarpa, Ganesha, Ashwini Kumara, Yama, Sarpa. In the same order, both in the odd Rashi and the even Rashi, it is the same. And the plotting is, the first division will fall in itself and the second division will sequentially fall in the next houses, and so it will complete 12 houses. Like, the first division of Aries will fall in Aries, the second division of Aries will fall in Taurus in the D12 chart from the D1. So the first division of the D1 Aries, 0 degree to 2 degree 30 minutes, will fall in the first, that is the Aries itself, second division in Taurus, third division in Gemini, fourth division in Cancer, fifth division in Leo, sixth division in Virgo, seventh in Libra, and so on till it finishes and comes till Pisces and closes down. So the same thing happens to Taurus, that is, the first division of Taurus, that is 0 degrees to 2 degrees 30 minutes, will fall in Taurus itself. The second division of Taurus, that is 2 degrees 30 minutes to 5 degrees in D1 of Taurus, will fall in the Gemini sign of D12. So that is how it completes, and it comes and finishes at Aries. So this happens for all the 12 Rashis. So this is also one of the important charts which we have to see. So the other important charts what we have is the D16 Shodashamsa. What we will do is that I will not tell how to do this. These are all, it will take a lot of length. I will put a notes in the description for important charts, not everything. D16 is also one important division which actually represents. What it represents is important, that I will tell you. D4 is Chaturthamsa, Chaturtha, fourth. And D16 is Shodasha. Why I am not so inclined on teaching this is because these both are materialistic amshas. So D12, we have different circles, like first circle, second circle, third circle, fourth circle and fifth circle. We have 5 circles. So the first circle is still D12, done. That is, we call this as the most important circle, the Shadvarga. The second circle is D16, D20 and D24. That's it. That is Shodashamsa, Vimshamsa, Chaturvimshamsa. D16, D20, D24. D16 is to understand the material luxuries, the luxury of whether this person will be enjoying the material luxuries, whether he will be healthy to enjoy it, whether he will be able to realize all his senses in a good way. So that is D16, whether he will be able to buy this, buy that and all those things. So the D20 is who he will worship, who he will really like. D20 is not to be simply taken as the god or the goddesses what a person worships. This is one thing which people have done wrong. It is not the god or the goddesses always. It is also the kind of a person whom the native would want to be his mentor, who would want to be his guru. So the D1, the D9 and the D20 charts are very important to find guru, to know which sort of a person, whether a rebellious person or a person who is teaching good aspects of life, whether a person polite in his way of teaching, or a person is in a tantric way of teaching. All these type of different type of gurus are there. We don't have gurus in the same way. So which type of a guru is applicable to this native is to be understood by D20. And also in the traditional level, we can understand whether he should be doing chanting or performing rituals, or he has to follow a strict routine of life. All these things also can be seen from D20. D24, I am talking about the second, level. D24 is Chaturvimshamsha, we also call it as Siddhamsha. This is to be seen to understand which line a person has to hold or which path the native has to follow to achieve success. What is success? Happiness. If people ask me what is success, it is foolishness to tell that I want to become Pope of Vatican, that is my success. And what after that? You want to die a Pope or live a Pope? I don't know. So people have different level of the success. So if a person tells that if I win Olympic gold, this is success to me. The other person will tell that if I build a house, that is a success to me because in my whole family nobody has their own house. So if, see, the level of success is depending on the perception and the exposure of the native and his horoscope. The same horoscope in a different country would behave differently. That is why Desha, Kala, Vartamana has to be seen. People simply should not bluntly argue that if two people are born on the same day at the same minute and the same latitudes and longitudes, will they have the same life? No. They will have similar life, but not same life. Why? Because the Atma which is taking birth is entirely different. They have very clearly told in our karma theory, Atma will not get afflicted, but the Atma is an individual. You know, remove all the affliction out of the Atma is an individual and it is unique. And if that unique Atma is going to get birth into a human yoni, that is into a human life, it will have a different repercussion. The other Atma which will get birth into the human yoni will have a different repercussion. So, the seed is more important. So, let us not go into such deep karmas, karma theories. So, the third, that is the D24 is the second one, last. Then you have D27 Bhamsha and then D30 Trimshamsha. This level is a very, very important level, which is the third level. We have D27 and D30, Bhamsha and Timshamsha, which we have to see to understand our difficulties, our obstacles, our hurdles, our challenges, and we need to see from Timshamsha our sorrows, our miseries, the pain what we go through, our earlier janma, karma, and why we are here, whether we can go out of it, go through it. So many things. So I don't go into these predictions because we do not have time. Most of the astrologers don't do this because every day, if a person is, see, it's like this. If there is a doctor who is highly, specialized in surgery and he opens up a clinic in, let's say, in our village, he will forget surgery in 2 years. He'll totally forget it. Why? Because he doesn't practice surgery. We'll have to give cough syrups. The people will only come for cough. Because we don't go for surgeries here. We don't go. We'll go to some other nursing home. So the guy who is coming here and practicing, he will never be a great surgeon. So the same thing is happening for astrologers here. From years together, from centuries together, people are simply asking the mundane questions. People have been asking questions of the within the first sphere. Why will an astrologer take his time out? Because he is busy answering those questions, making his life happen. Astrologer also has his own life and he is also into the samsara. Only when astrologers really think that we have to come out of this and live a better, bigger, attend to all the other questions, only then we can do this. It is very difficult to do this. Not all astrologers can do it. Even me, I don't attempt D30 and all those things regularly. It's very difficult. Why? Because we don't practice every day. That is why it is difficult. It takes a lot of time. So, and the accuracy is also difficult because we have not done 1000 charts on D30. So, I am just openly accepting because I don't think not many astrologers will even accept that if they ask D30, they'll tell, yeah, we know D30. I also know D30. To know, yes, we all know. to whether we can practice it in the highest level with highest accuracy, I don't know. So after D30 we have D40, D45, which is Khavedamsha and Akshavedamsha, which is the next sphere. This sphere is of higher relevance, and it would be better we will talk about it later, but that is the sphere. The last one, I think everybody knows it, but the last one, Shashtiamsha, D60, which tells you where you are, where you go, and what you are doing. Oh my God, we know that, but we don't know how to look at it. Why it's not happening is the accuracy when we go into the minor charts loses its relevance, because our birth time calculation is very, very, you know, marginal. It is not accurate. Like if D60, for example, is 30 degrees divided by 60, that is half a degree. Half a degree means our birth time accuracy should be within 2 minutes. So you lose that 2 minutes. It's 2 minutes is the range. Even 10 seconds this side or that side, it will go to a different lagna. So the astrologer himself will be like, whether he is seeing the right lagna or not, he doesn't know. So you cannot do rectification in D60 and D30 and above. It's very difficult. I keep getting calls by people asking that whether you will do rectification of the divisional charts of the higher level. I'll tell Babu, I don't know, I can't do that. I'm very sorry. You need to find the best astrologer in the world. Please do it. I can't do it. So because it will take my whole lifetime to even, first me, I have to study. You know, we all are not super proficient to go for D30, D42, D45 and D, and then you go to D60, D40, D45, D60. God bless those levels. But anyway, these levels are, once again I'll repeat, D16 Sodashamsha, D20 Vimshamsha, D24 Chaturvimshamsha, D27 Bhamsha, D30 Trimshamsha, D40 Khavedamsha, D45 Akshavedamsha, D60 Shashtiamsha. So how to plot this? If I am able to give you, I think I should be giving you D16 and D24, which are very important. So these two things we can type it over and put it in the description box. So it will be easy for you to, you know, understand. So if it is possible, we will do it today itself with the Dwadashamsa plotting thing. So thank you very much for today's video. The next coming videos will be about yogas, and most probably I'll be starting it from Monday onwards. So Saturday and Sunday, let us talk about some topics which are actually in between. We have left out many topics are there. Let me talk about some relevant topics which are actually important and also make sense at this particular time and juncture of our classes. Thank you very much.